Hello everyone, welcome to the series of MVC 5 tutorial, and in this session we are going to see the action method. So action methods are the public methods of your controller. Now all of you know that controller is a class, and class have some methods and property. So whatever public method you will write in your class, that methods will be termed as action methods. Now they are just like your normal method, but with the following restrictions. So let us see what is the first restriction. So the first restriction is that your action method must be public. Okay, your action method must be public. It cannot be private or it cannot be protected. So basically your controller class can have this kind of methods, private method, protected method, public method, but only public methods are termed as action method. Now let us see what is the next restriction. Now you cannot overload your action method. Actually in some case you can overload and in some case you cannot overload. We are going to see this particular restriction in detail and practically also, but for time being remember that you cannot overload an action method. Now let us see what is the next restriction. So the next restriction is it cannot be a static method. Okay, it cannot be a static method. So whenever you are going to create or whenever you are going to write an action method for controller class, remember this thing: it should be public, you cannot overload the action method. Now all of you know the meaning of overload. You cannot have a method having multiple method having same name but with a different parameters, that is called as overloading. Okay, so you cannot have an overload of an action method, and as I told you we are going to see this part in detail and practically. Now the last important restriction is it cannot be a static method. Now see, I hope all of you know what is a static method or how it is called by how it is called. Basically static methods are called by class, not by an object, right? So whenever we execute our MVC application, the controller instance get created, or in simple language I'll say a controller object is get created. Okay, and if your action method is going to be static, definitely it cannot be accessible by an object. So therefore your action method cannot be static, because non-static methods are accessed by an object and static methods are accessed or called by class. Then the next important thing, why it should be public? Because outside our application we can only access those methods which are public. That's why your action method should be public, because controller class object is created at runtime and then after action method get called. So only the public methods of class are accessible outside the class. That's why it should be public. Okay, now I hope both these terms are clear to you, why it should be public and why it should not be static, and why we cannot overload. We are going to see this part in detail. Now let us see one example of an action method. So just have a look. We have a student controller. Okay, according to the rule we name our controller as student, which is ending with controller word. Okay, then the next important thing, it should be inherited from the controller class. This is the base class already given by the .NET framework, and it resides in system.web.mvc namespace. Okay, now we are having one method in our class, and since it is a public method, it is an action method. We can call it as an action method. Now as you can observe here, your action method return type is action result. Okay, what is your return type of an action method? It is of type action result. So actually your action method can return various type of result. Here I define action result as a return type because it is a base class of all the result type. We are going to see this part in detail again. Okay, now Here, your action method is returning a view. Okay. Now, if you observe carefully here, we are not returning an object of action result. Basically, what is our return type? Our return type is action result. But what we are returning here? We are returning a view method. Now, how it is possible? Actually, this view method is defined in our base class. Okay, this view method is defined in our base class. So what is our base class? A controller base class. And this view method is defined in our controller class. So whenever we give call to this, it is a responsibility of this method to create an object and return that. So totally responsibility is taken by this method. We need not to create an object of action result, then assign some values to it, and then after return it. It is not necessary. You can directly give call to the view method. Again, there are various methods depending on your result type. Now let us see what are these various result types available in MVC. First of all, we'll understand what is an action result. So basically, if you are going to write an action method, it is basically recommended that you should return a value of type action result. Okay, actually you can return anything, you can return integer, you can return string, anything, but it is recommended that you should return action result. Okay, now what is an action result? It is also a class. Okay, rather than I say it is a base class of all the result classes. Okay, so there are more than one result classes, and action result is a base class of all the result classes. Okay, now in the next slide I will list all the result classes that are available in MVC. Okay, so if you are not sure, then in that case you can specify the return type as action result since it is a base class, or if you are sure, you can specify the specific result type. Okay, now all of you are familiar with inheritance. According to the principle of inheritance, your base class object can hold derived class, right? So if you are not sure, you can specify action result, or if your method is returning multiple types of result classes, okay, in that case also you can specify return type as an action result. Definitely we are going to see this in this practically also. So let us see what are the various result classes available in MVC. Okay, so it is good practice to define the specific result classes if you know it in advance. Okay, so the first result class is view result class. Okay, the class name is view result. As we saw in the previous slide, action result is a base class, and from this base class all these result classes are inherited, or you can say derived. Okay, so if you want to return a view, okay, now all of you know view represents HTML, right? Suppose you want to display or render HTML, in that case you have to choose return type as view result. Okay, and for that, a view method of base class controller is responsible for creating object of view result and returning it. You need not to create view result object specifically. It is totally a responsibility of view method. So whenever you are sure that you are going to return a view, you are going to represent an HTML, specify your result class as type view result. If you do not want to return anything, in that case you have to specify the result as empty result. Okay, now there is no method available. Whenever there is no method available, in that case you have to create an object of this result class and return that specific object. Okay, now the next is contained result. If you just want to return a string or whatever number, whatever, you do not want to render HTML, in that case you can specify the result class as contained result, and for that the method available is content. So this content method will create an object of content result class and then return it. And as I told you, all these methods are defined in our base class. You have to just give call from your controller. Now, if you want to return any file, okay? If you want to return any file, you want to display any file, or you want to allow user to download any file, PDF file, text file, whatever. In that case, you can specify return type as file result, and for that, a method available is file. Suppose you want to return JavaScript result from your controller to the from your controller. In that case, you can specify JavaScript result. Okay. Now, the next one is JSON result. JSON results are basically used in combination with AJAX. So if you want to return the result of AJAX, you can specify the JSON result. So whenever we are going to study AJAX, at that time I will tell you how to return a JSON result, and for that method is JSON. Now next one is redirect result. Suppose you want to redirect to a new URL, okay? In that case, you can use redirect result. For example, on your web page there is a link of Facebook page, okay? So to redirect to that page, your return type should be what? Redirect result. We are going to see this in practically also. So the base class method is redirect. Now the next one is redirect to root result. Suppose you want to redirect to the action or action method of same controller or another controller. In that case, you will use redirect to root result. Now we'll see what is the difference between redirect result and redirect to root result practically also. So just let me complete what are the action results available in MVC, then we'll see all these things practically. Now redirect to root result can be returned using these two methods, redirect to root and redirect to action. Both of these are just alternative to each other. You can use any one. Basically, redirect to action is easy as compared to redirect to root result. Now the next one is partial view result. It is also a useful concept in MVC, and one of the view type means either your view can be an entire view or a partial view. So partial view result is again used mostly with an AJAX. So while studying AJAX, we are going to see how to use partial view result, and it also represents a HTML, and for that the available method is partial view. The next one is HTTP unauthorized result. Okay, again there is no method available, so in that case we have to create our own object of HTTP unauthorized result. This is mainly used with authentication and authorization. So while studying authentication and authorization, we are going to create an object of this. Okay, thank you.